Finally from us this Sunday, we invited the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee, Senator Lindsey Graham of South Carolina, to the show this week. We were told he was unavailable. We wanted to ask Graham about his views of the mounting evidence that President Trump's team was pushing Ukraine to publicly announce an investigation into the Bidens, and that the $400 million in aid and the White House meeting that the government of Ukraine desperately wanted would not happen without that announcement. Graham's public statements on the matter have been confusing. On September 25th, after the White House released that rough call transcript between President Trump and Ukrainian President Zelensky, Graham called the call a, quote, nothing non-quid pro quo burger.
If you're looking for a circumstance where the President of the United States was threatening the Ukraine with cutting off aid unless they investigate his political opponent, you would be very disappointed. That does not exist.
Then in October, Graham told Axios that other evidence beyond the rough transcript might change his mind.
If you could show me that, you know, Trump actually was engaging in a quid pro quo outside the phone call, that would be very disturbing.
We now have reams of evidence, testimony from multiple Trump administration diplomats and national security officials, current and former, suggesting that outside that phone call, Ambassador Gordon Sondland, Rudy Giuliani, Acting White House Chief of Staff Mick Mulvaney, all were pushing Ukraine to investigate the Bidens if they wanted that aid and that White House meeting. Now, the Judiciary Committee chairman has a different and brand new take.
What I can tell you about the Trump policy toward the Ukraine, it was incoherent. It depends on who you talk to. They seem to be incapable of forming a quid pro quo.
Coherence is not particularly evident in Chairman Graham's position on this impeachment inquiry. On October 9th, he tweeted, quote, if House Democrats refuse to release the full transcript of former Ukraine Ambassador Kurt Volker's testimony, as requested by Republican Congressman Jordan, it will be an abuse of power. And then this week, as that transcript and many others were released, the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee said he was not going to read any of the transcripts.
Do you plan on reading these transcripts that were released?
No. I don't care what anybody else says about the phone call. The phone call, I've made up my own mind, is fine. I think this is a bunch of BS.
Beyond the fact that reading these transcripts is actually, you know, Graham's job as Senate Judiciary Committee chairman, his statement recalled nothing so much as former Indiana Republican Congressman Earl Landgrebe in 1974, when asked by an Associated Press reporter about a new set of damning Nixon tapes, Congressman Landgrebe said, quote, don't confuse me with the facts. I've got a closed mind. I'm going to stick with my president. Now, we see plenty of folks like that in Congress today, but it is jarring to hear similar sentiments from Graham, who as House impeachment manager during the Clinton impeachment and then under the tutelage of his former mentor, the late John McCain, saw and perhaps still sees himself as someone willing to be independent, with allegiance not to any politician, but to the public, to the rule of law, to the U.S. Constitution. Graham spoke on the Senate floor after the loss of his friend McCain.
Don't look to me to replace this man. Look to me to remember what he was all about and try to follow in his footsteps.
Is Senator Lindsey Graham trying to follow in the footsteps of John McCain? Or is he trying to follow in the footsteps of Earl Landgrebe?